Hey foodies, Anthony from Matches Net here, and this video starts our long voyage of eating at every Taco Bell fast food restaurant in the country. Oops, did I say country? I meant county. As of August 2024, there are over 7,980 Taco Bells within the borders of the United States. I had realized that my original goal would have been an arduous task, as well as really expensive. This is why I had asked Taco Bell via Twitter, or X, to help offset some of the costs. Let's see what they've said. Okay. So, lacking a response, I decided to reduce my focus from the country to a county in Ohio and ask Taco Bell again. I guess this video is going to need to perform really well with its Google AdSense revenue. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and do not skip those ads because I'm going to need all of the financial help that I can get for this trip. Plus, if you turn on notifications, you will be informed of future content releases. Anyway, the revised plan is simple. We are going to start in Ohio with the county west of Cleveland, Lorain County. It has 13 Taco Bells compared to Chicago County's vastly superior number. Even if I were still going for a national run, I would still want to start off slow on the first day. So Taco Bell may be my favorite fast food restaurant, but it's not my stomach's favorite. At each Taco Bell, one item will be purchased via the app with a gift card so that we can maintain a tally. I will also screenshot the receipt. I am going to try to mix things up by not ordering the same item twice in a row. I will then photograph each Taco Bell's exterior prior to picking up my order. I will not be taking any photographs or videos from inside of the Taco Bells, but I will probably provide my thoughts on each unique food item. I anticipate an approximate 100-mile drive to complete the circuit and hit each location. The trip in total should take maybe 4 hours, traffic permitting. I will start near Lake Erie on the west side of the county, then work my way south. On the way north along the east side of the county, I will work my way in a zigzag pattern through the interior. So I guess that's it. Let the soon-to-be very gassy games begin. Alrighty, I'm in the truck, and so just a few bits of housekeeping here. First off, the temperature is going to be in the high 80s, low 90s, so it's going to be hot. Also, there's a chance of thunderstorms, so I might be driving through some rain. Obviously, I'm recording the travel between locations, starting from the first Taco Bell to the last, so you can see how the weather develops over the course of the trip. Another thing that I noticed is that the first there's like a page here that I keep track on. First four Taco Bells are literally a mile apart from each other, mile quarter. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to get a drink from the first one and then some food items for the first three and then eat them. But of course, I would do the blogging part as I am at each Taco Bell. So I think that's the approach for this trip. So I ended up ordering a cheesy gordita crunch. I don't think I've ever had one before, and if I did, it was like when it first came out. I also got a large Mountain Dew. Now, the cheesy gordita crunch was actually free. I had to use it up by the end of the week, so I used it now. So we'll add that to the pile. I also took a picture of my display. We have nearly 3/4 a tank of gas, and then we're tracking the actual trip. So I set that when we got to this first Taco Bell. And now, I guess, off into the second one. So, for the second order, I decided to do something a little bit more expensive because I had broken down $50 for 13 locations, about $4 each location. I went a little crazy, got a $6 item, but I've never had one before, and it's a Cantina burrito. So we'll check how that is, but I guess off to number three. And I want to stress something real quick. So I was kind of wrong. The location of the first Taco Bell versus the second Taco Bell is about 4.5 miles apart. But the next three, so like number two, which I'm at, three, and then four, are literally main roads apart. It's weird. It is so close together. Okay, on stop number three here, and I got two spicy potato soft tacos because they didn't have nacho fries. I think I missed that by a few weeks. Nacho fries are awesome. Nacho cheese dipping in. Oh, so good. But anyway, stop four, another main road away. Man, they're so close together. So for this fourth stop, I picked up another drink, this time Diet Pepsi, and what I'm going to do now, first off, it's over 90 degrees, and going in and out of the vehicle from air conditioning to heat is actually giving me a headache, and I'm hungry, so I'm going to eat. So I'll show you what the stuff looks like once I unbag it. So this is how everything was packaged in those bags. This has some... salsa, it's avocado based, the Cantina burrito. These are the tacos. Every time I have a taco from Taco Bell, they're always never totally closed, and I just make a mess, so I had to clean that up. And then here is the gordita. So I'm gonna open these up and we can take a look at those. So tacos, this is the potato soft taco. Yeah, what you expect. Here's the gordita. And the one thing I hate about these in particular, anything with these soft shells like this, is that the bag sticks to it, or the wrapper, and sometimes you rip off some of it. And then, of course, here is the Cantina burrito. So they all look really good. I'm going to eat them because, well, frankly, headache, hot weather, and the next location is so far away. I mean, relatively speaking, it's rather, you know, same county, but it's like the furthest one away from everywhere else. Before we head to the next location, which is in Wellington, I'm going to get a little bit of how my food was. Very good. I've never had the Cantina burrito before. Without the avocado sauce, it's okay. But with the avocado sauce, a nice kick. Really, really enjoyed that. The spicy potato soft taco, it's always good. I just, you know, nice potassium intake. And then, of course, the chalupa, the inside shell was soggy, but that happens. Although that does remind me that Taco Bell keeps warm really well. Like, if I were to go to Taco Bell McDonald's at the same time, Taco Bell's food would be warm when I get home. Taco Bell or McDonald's would be cold. So that is just a thing that popped in my head as I'm eating this stuff, some of which I had for like 20 minutes sitting in this car from, you know, the one from the first location. So yeah, it was all nice and warm. Obviously the stuff I ordered, the most recent one would be the warmest, but you know what I mean. I suspect that the next location, it says it's a Mickey Mart, which makes me think Taco Bell Express. But as I was on my way to this this location, I'm thinking to myself, you know what? I bet you it's one of those double store things, kind of like he had a Taco Bell KFC, Long John Silver's type of situation. We used to have a long time ago a joint convenience store restaurant set up here in Lorain. Not anymore. But now that I'm thinking about it, I'm thinking, you know what? Grafton or Wellington, wherever we're going, is such a small town that actually makes perfect sense. Somebody with a convenience store franchised the Taco Bell and threw it on the side of their buildings. That's exactly what happened here. So I think that's what we're running into when we get to the next location. Okay, so we're at the Wellington, which is the furthest south location. And first off, this lemon thing, this lemon vanilla freeze is fantastic. Second, it was a combination gas station, convenience store, Taco Bell, Domino's, which is really just a unique combination as far as I'm aware. But I wanted to mention a trip that Moose, Wenzel, and I took. It's on the Games Channel. We went to the one of the last CC's pizza in the United States. And it's a good video to watch because we go through Mansfield, Columbus, and end up in Cincinnati. but it reminded me of a related trip where Moose Wenzel and I went to Mansfield and we visited a Taco John's that was attached to a gas station and a Subway. Because when I saw this building, it's exactly what popped in my head. So yeah, notable thing. But I mean, it's like 97 degrees now. This thing is fantastic. Just the sweetness of the vanilla and the bitter sourness of the lemon, fantastic. Okay, so we're in Grafton now. We're officially halfway. This is because obviously I've been in there. I got this G2 Gatorade low-calorie fruit punch. It tastes like Gatorade. Tastes like fruit punch, maybe? Nah. I don't know if I've never had it before. And that's also part of the goal of this trip for me was to try things I haven't tried before. So the one thing I realized on the way to the Wellington combo storefront, I guess, was that the Cantina burrito with these, I put that avocado sauce on it, was actually starting to burn my mouth. So that freeze, which I have yet to actually finish, but there's going to be a little while before I get to the next restaurant. I was like, well, I'm probably gonna need a drink. And so finish up the one, get to the other. Where do we go? We're heading towards the Cuyahoga County border. And I don't know how far that is from here. I guess I'll find out when I get there. But as you might have seen, I occasionally taking pictures of the interiors. If there's nobody sitting in there, I'll take a picture. Because there's some unique looks to these Taco Bells. The one that I first started with, I've never been inside before. It's a very interesting look. Same thing with this one. I've actually never been here before at all. And similar. The spacing is a little bit different. But I guess off to North Ridgeville. You know how like some restaurants have a secret menu? Taco Bell's, some of them here actually have a secret item that you really can't get without the app or knowing what to say at the register. And that item is a chili cheese burrito. This thing is stacked for like $2.25, I think, something like that. And it's hot. It is really hot. Definitely an interesting item. It used to be on menus for a while, and now it's kind of like, well, if you know the password, and you gotta get through the three doors, you can order one. So that's what I did. And so after North Ridgeville, we end up going into Elyria, and I think fun fact, the next locations are literally, I can go one way or the other. They're on the same road, but two separate sides. One near North Ridgeville, which is probably the one I should go to because I think it might be actually closer. And then one in downtown Elyria. Then we scooch through Elyria to the Midway Mall. The mall is dying, but somehow they built a new Taco Bell last year. Whatever. And then we start going along what's called Detroit Road, which runs all the way through Cleveland. And there is literally just a Taco Bell after Taco Bell after Taco Bell the next couple of towns where we eventually end the trip. So I'm going to eat this burrito and try to pace myself. It has been about 2 hours since I last ate because, between like Grafton and Wellington, I just got drinks. So here we go. So I forgot there was a Taco Bell location between the North Ridgeville location and the one in downtown Elyria and the border of North Ridgeville location. So I'm there now. I ended up getting a cheesy double beef burrito. You know, after that bean burrito, I'm back to basically being full from the earlier when I ate in Amherst. So I'm kind of like, you know, I'm a little full, man. I'm like, the Gatorade's, yeah, I finished the frozen, the Gatorade's down to here. The Gatorade tastes like popsicle water. Like, you ever get those popsicles and then you let it to melt? That's what it tastes like. It tastes like Tropical Punch melted popsicle. But anyway, on to, I guess we're going to do the north location bordered one. It's still technically in Elyria. So this time I went back to Diet Pepsi because we got the last of them coming on. We got Elyria, the Elyria downtown Elyria Mall. Then we have Sheffield Village, and then finally Avon. I'm gonna confer with the worksheet here. Yep, that is correct. Four left. I have no idea what I'm gonna get. I feel like whatever I'm gonna get, because I mean I still haven't even eaten the double cheesy beef burrito, whatever it's called. Is it going to end up being like, I'll get to them later tonight or something? Because there's no chance I'm eating anymore right now. Okay, so we're downtown Elyria. I got a chicken enchilada burrito. You can hear it in my voice how excited I was. It is like, literally school just got out, so that place was packed. So it took a few minutes. It was already done when I got into the building, like literally in the 30 seconds between ordering and getting there. But I had to wait for a crowd of kids to get through the line before I even got there. But I guess next, looking at the cheat sheet, Midway Mall. Alrighty, so Midway Mall Taco Bell bean burrito, and in case anybody asks or wondering why I'm getting burritos, because yes, they keep warm longer, but they're also easier to warm up. It's really difficult to warm up a taco when you leave it in the fridge for a while, but a burrito, perfectly easy enough to stick in a microwave, so that is why I'm ordering burritos. So for my next to last stop here in Sheffield Village, I got a beef grilled cheese burrito. I think I've maybe gotten this once before, but a burrito again, so reheat. And then the salesperson decided to put my order together, gave me a free, obviously I had to fill the cup up, a free drink. So because it's happy hour, whatever they call it, and it's like a dollar, but he was like, have a freebie. So I got the dull strawberry lemonade, and it again has that popsicle water taste, kind of like the Gatorade. So, yeah, it's okay. Now off to the final location in Avon. Okay, final store, Avon. Got 12 Cinnabons. Never had them before. I don't think I've actually ever eaten Cinnabon before. Usually, I don't dive into these type of cinnamony sweet things. So I guess what we'll do is I'll open this up and we'll see. I mean, I'm going to put the burritos away. I'm going to try one of these Cinnabon things.
So the one thing that I witnessed on this trip was that the temperature actually got over 100 degrees. It's 104 at one point, but I only caught it at 101. But they smell real cinnamony. Oh. Okay. So I was wondering where the cinnamon dip was. Again, I've never had these before. It's in the inside. I mean, it is weird. Like, it's warm on the outside and cold on the inside. But, like, it's brilliant. Oh, my God. It's so good. As I get the cinnamon off my fingers. So, this is the, I think that's the cheese one, the grilled one, bean burrito. I think this is the chicken enchilada, and this is the beefy. So, yeah, these are going to go, like, in a bag and then into the fridge. Oh, my God, these are so good. Wow. I have made a mess.
I mean, the things are spectacular. Mmm. And I was hoping not to eat the whole bag here, but I mean, I think it's a 12-pack. Mmm. I mean, I wasn't even hungry, but this is phenomenal. Oh, definitely probably the best thing I've had today. Although that vanilla lemonade, real close. But let's get home and wrap this up. Well, the end of day one is upon us. It has actually taken nearly 3.5 hours to complete the voyage, and I am happy to be home. I ended up driving approximately 76 miles, which cost almost $11 in gasoline. I spent just under $45 at the Lorain County Taco Bells. That makes the grand total for today nearly $56. Giving it some additional thought, the Cinnabon Delights were the clear winner. The vanilla cream limonada freeze took second place. And in third, I am going with the Katina chicken burrito. My stomach is really not happy with me, so it's going to be a little while before I work up the courage to try again with another county or even a different restaurant. Tell me in the comments your thoughts in this video. Did you like what you saw, and how was your experience with it? Thanks for watching, and please remember to like and subscribe.